was verkocht.
How hard was it?
Starting my day with a coffee. Okay, let's talk about MBA here in Germany. Just for the background, somebody who has recently tuned in or don't know much about my story, I'm an MBA student here in Germany, writing my thesis at the moment, almost at the last stage of submission. So that gives me complete right to call myself a graduate, almost a graduate from Germany. Before I walk you through how in general MBA courses are here in Germany, let me walk you through a few years back. So when this first thought which came to my mind that I want to do MBA, one thing as obvious anybody would think of is how much more money am I going to earn if I do MBA, right? Because MBAs are never free anywhere in the world, okay? There may be some courses related to business here in Germany, probably free in public university, but this degree, MBA, is not free because it's highly regarded when it comes to getting a job. When I look back now, I feel that that was not a right question. I shouldn't have compared my how much money am I going to make versus what I was already making with the degree what I want to acquire. The right question, if now you're planning to come to Germany, you should ask yourself is, how much, once you do this course, once you do MBA degree, how much more of an interesting person is it going to make you? I think when we study, we not just study here in Germany. It is more with the excursion, going out, involving a lot of projects, people, ideas, and not just ideas, but big ideas. You're trying to find that one idea which actually creates a multi-million dollar company and all that. And ultimately being taught by some of the smartest people who you can find in the education business. I think that should be the way of looking at your MBA. So before you look for monetary gains or cost benefits, you have to make sure you keep this in mind that here in Germany, you have to have work experience if you want to study MBA. Now there are colleges here in Germany, in Berlin in fact, they have started taking students who have minimum of 2 years of work experience, but top-notch colleges expect you to have at least 3 to 4 to 5 years of work experience. So the more you have, the better for you. During this time, you're not working, okay? There is no real income coming in for you. So make sure that you take this decisions of going studying MBA especially very wisely, because you're definitely paying a reasonably sizable amount of tuition fees to a college. So the main questions which I want to address in this video is why Germany is suitable for you to do MBA right now. In my point of view, again, all these observations which I'm making right here is my experience, okay? This is tried and true. It's not something which I read on internet. Second point I want to talk about is what is the job opportunities you can expect after MBA and what kind of salary range you can expect. So it ultimately depends upon your past experience plus whether or not you've done internship or any kind of part-time job which actually leads you to a full-time contract. Third thing which I would like to talk about is what are the subjects am I studying in my MBA and how is the exam pattern like, a bit more about course itself. Alright guys, I'm gonna start with the very basic question of why Germany for MBA studies. Alright, I assure you that I'm not gonna bore you with my answers. I have made 5 quick points to answer this question. High economy, growing deficit in Germany's labor force, cost of living, blue ocean strategy, and 18 months job search visa. Let me start with blue ocean strategy point. Now, in a very layman's language, what it means is, it's a very fancy business term, what a lot of people use it in corporate, is creating your own market and not competing in the existing ones. For example, Unilever and P&G. They have a FMCG line wherein they are competing each other with household items like shampoo, oil and all that, right? So the third person comes up with, he says, I'm gonna make avocado shampoos or aloe vera something. You know, that's a niche in that market. That's what you gotta do right now when it comes to doing studies now. Germany was never ever a conventional country for a lot of people, especially people from India, to come and study. Germany was always known for technological power, not for studies. It has recently come into mainstream now. Going back to the point of why to study in Germany is because if you look at the social political situation all across the world, not just in Germany, In if you talk about US, where the top-notch Ivy League universities are, especially for MBA, they are way too expensive. And I don't know, if you have good scores, then you can get into. But if I'm talking from a point of someone who comes from a middle-class family, they can't really afford it. You can't go to UK anymore because of Brexit. You can't go to Australia because it's already way too expensive to survive there. You can't go to Canada anyways because you know the level of competition you're gonna face there is almost as same as India. Tell me, where are you gonna go then? Germany is the most powerful economy within Europe. It is single-handedly handling whole of Europe. I've said this multiple times, fourth largest economy in the world. So why not? The other point on my list is striving economy. Economy is stable, it's very safe, it's not fluctuating, because that's how the market is, and it is good for your job, full-time job. Growing deficit in Germany's labor force. Yes, that's true. One of the major reason of this is the age group here is higher and higher. So the normal age group of a country like India is, it's somewhere between 27 to 29. It's a young country. India is a young country, but here there is an aging population. So a lot of people are getting older at the same time because of the wars and everything, you know, from the history. That's why to tackle that situation, Blue Card was recently launched. It didn't exist before. Just to tackle this labor situation, they want a lot of people here now. They want skilled force, not a lot of people, but skilled force. Germany's market is a skilled force. So this point actually goes back to my Blue Ocean strategy point, wherein I spoke about you have to create your own niche. Yes. For example, you start working for a company and this company has a market in India, they're doing the business in India, so you can be a market expert and company will definitely hire you if you're skillful enough because you fit in that bracket. And keep this out of your mind. Don't think that doing MBA or studies here is magically gonna change you in a night. That's never gonna happen. All right, going further, cost of living wise. Tell me which country in the world you can survive in 500 euros. You know, worst case situation I'm talking about, 500 euros. Nowhere, man. To know a bit more about cost of living, I'm gonna link it in the description. I've made 4-part video, accommodation, food, insurance, and internet thing. So check the link in the description. I have covered Blue Ocean strategy thing. Yes, after studying, this is one of the advantages. And why? Because you get 18 months job seeker search visa. All right, seeker's visa is different, but as a student, when you study here, you really get 18 months to find a job. So technically 2 years of studies and 18 months. So I'm sure if you're skillful enough to find a job, you will find it within this time frame. All right, guys, so the second main part of this video is tell me more about MBA course, which is this course what I'm doing. I've made certain bullet points. What subjects I'm studying? I have a 3-semester course which I'm doing right now. What is the ranking system like? Because I do get a lot of questions like, how is that college like? And what is the ranking and all that? I'm gonna talk about that. ECTS system, thesis, is attendance really important here in German universities or not? Campus placement, like in India it happens, and what is the fees like, what you can expect? Okay, let me break this myth. A lot of people have this, they always keep asking me, where do you study and all that. I study in a private institution here, it's called IUBH, International University of Bad Honnef Berlin campus. I'm doing 3-semester course there, okay? It's an MBA course, what I'm doing. Subjects, what I have studied right now, I'm writing my thesis, as I've already mentioned in the beginning of the vlog. Corporate finance, leadership, change management, marketing, economics, managerial economics. Yeah, and first semester they were basics. Second semester I more of it, I specialized myself into marketing area. And the third semester, so first semester is a classroom sessions where you have to go to class, attend the lectures where professors are teaching you. Second semester again happens the same thing, so every end of semester you have to give a written exams. But on third semester you have to write thesis, and that's where I am right now. This course of mine is of 90 ECTS course, so one semester is of 30 ECTS. All right, so I've already completed 60 ECTS. I'm gonna get more 30 ECTS from thesis. That's what makes 90 ECTS for my course. I want to talk about this important point, ranking system. For the last 6 months, I've been doing counseling for students, and they always ask, like, tell me a college which has a high ranking, a good ranking. Now, if you Google that, you will find top 10 business schools in Germany, which I completely agree of. Like, you know, I'm sitting 10 minutes away from ESMT College, which is shown on Google. But does that mean that it makes me ineligible for certain jobs available in the market? No, it doesn't. Let me explain you this in a little bit more systematic way now. I remember in India, this is how the conversation goes when you're sitting in front of an employer. Where did you do your MBA from? I'm a student of IIM Ahmedabad, last year pass out. You know, the employers, if there are three people sitting there, the whole mood changes in the room, like, wow, it's a big deal now. It is supposed to be a big deal. It's one of the top colleges for management. Hold on. Then there's another candidate who comes and gives an interview at the same time, but from a very local college, Sitaram Management School. Just an immediate follow-up question comes out is, where is that? Okay. You know, people don't take you serious there. Let me tell you this, it doesn't happen here in Germany. People care about what are you good at. People only care about how can you be helpful for my business here? Yes, education is one of the criteria. They look at it and they will look at your grades too. But if you're extraordinary at something, then for sure you're just, you know, going with the full force. But I also feel that not every IIM guy is capable of doing everything in the world the way it's been portrayed. Or not a guy passing out from MIT is one of the best top guy who can do everything. No, it's all at the end of the day, it's a game of skills. If you're good at something, you will gain it. It's just like, what is the worth of guitar for me? Zero. But what is the worth of guitar for A.R. Rahman? $1 billion, man. It's same logic. So all in all, that's what I'm trying to say. Don't worry about ranking system here in Germany. Nobody cares. Well, there can be exceptions where people are like, oh wow, you're from that college and all that. In general, nobody really cares about. You have equal opportunity what others have. So what's the difference, right? There's not much difference. Yes, the difference comes in about probably the education level, what you're getting and he's getting. But that doesn't stop you from going out in the market and learning more. See, at the end of the day, that's what I believe in, that if I want to learn something, I will go very hard on that. Very, very hard. That's what I believe in. Like, if you're really passionate about something, but again, trying, just see this whole conversation, it's going somewhere else now. Okay, I want to bring it back to the ranking part. Yes, don't worry about this. Rankings don't really matter here in Germany. Let's go ahead. ECTS is a credit system here. Every semester is for 30 credits. And that's what you got to acquire. Thesis, I'm writing my thesis and I'm going to soon talk a bit more about my topic and everything, but right now I can't. Attendance, yes, let me tell you, attendance is a big deal here in Germany now. So some colleges where they saw that students don't really show up, then they started putting in my college, yes, there is attendance. Yes, when I used to go to university, I had to go to university almost 5 days, almost for, I don't know, from morning till the evening, and good amount of gap, and then there is a class from 6 o'clock. There used to be a class from 11 o'clock in the morning till 1 o'clock, and then directly at 6:30 in the evening till 8:30. So you can expect late college also here. So to talk about college campus placement, a lot of people have also asked me like, hey, am I gonna get a job after that or not? It completely and solely depends upon how much effort and hard work are you willing to put in. Nobody can help you out if you're not willing to help yourself. Yes, it's a cliche. Have you heard about it? Yes, even I've heard about it. So make sure that you have your ways out to find a job, find an internship, find a part-time job, create your network, and you know, do whatever it takes to ultimately to get a job. That's what I meant. But what has started happening recently is there is always a career cell in the campus. All right, there'll be a person responsible for you to getting an opportunity on the door, and from which is like, hey, listen, there is a interview happening for X position or intern, you know. Then your job is to go to that place, give interview. If you get through, it's get through. And if not, then it's up to you. Talking about the last part, fees is a highly important thing. So the range of fees you can expect is from 18,000 euros to 46,000 plus euros amount of fees you can expect as an MBA fees. Alright guys, so the last part of this video is what kind of jobs you can expect after your MBA. Now, you must have heard in India, this is such a pretty normal thing. When I was doing my bachelor especially, you know, there was that trend because of social norms and pressure that, oh, at least, you know, you have to be 10th pass. And then the trend changed, or at least you have to be 12th pass. Then the trend changed, or at least now you have to be bachelor's. Then the trend right now, I guess, is all about MBA. At least you have to be MBA or master's, right? If you're one of those, or if you're one of those who was doing something and you felt like, okay, let me do a distance learning of MBA, probably that might help me out. And you did that also and still it didn't work out anything. Life still remains the same. It's like a bouquet and you added another flower to that. No, you have to work on the soil. You have to increase the fertility level. It's just like that. It's skills. If you're good at talking, you can be a good orator. And it's a skill. Soft skills are the hardest to learn. Just like you can't be reading all day long about push-ups. You have to do that. It's all in the practice. Okay, without getting too philosophical about this, I've made several points which I want to keep in front of you guys. So first point is, depends totally on your past experience. If you have done 6 years of mechanical engineering work in Volkswagen in India, then definitely you can expect something similar jobs, but with a higher salary job. Yes, experience matters a lot. You can actually use this website called PayScale. I'm going to link it in the description. Make sure that you go there, check it out. Yeah, it's mainly used by employers and employee both. Learn German language. If you want to come to Germany and want to work at a industrial level, engineering level, or whatever actually, make sure that you're linguistically strong enough if you want to stay here. But if you're someone who can't really put in the efforts of learning a language, it will be damn difficult. On the other side, Germany is not the end of the world. All right, if you have plans to go back, if you have plans to go back to an English-speaking countries, anyways, German education or German university degree has a higher value anywhere you go in the world. So, third point is my LinkedIn strategy. I don't use LinkedIn just like Facebook. I use LinkedIn to connect with a lot of people, influentials and decision makers in the company and HR directors and everybody. Make sure you have a very nicely updated LinkedIn profile and a Xing profile. X-I-N-G Xing is a LinkedIn of Germany. So all German companies and authorities and everybody are there. So make sure that it's speak and span perfectly written, everything is in proper. So next point is about internship. Try to do 2 internships at least while you're studying. So when you're doing this internship and when you complete this, try to get the review or, you know, a recommendation written on your LinkedIn, because it's highly used here in Germany. People here will go through your resume, your cover letter, and then your LinkedIn also. So make sure that that's on point with a lot of recommendation and people are endorsing your skills. That's your past former boss. So that'll be also a great strategy. Internship, I've already made a video. I'm also going to link it in the description. Go check that out. It's a very straightforward. Try to get internship and, you know, work in your area. I've told you guys multiple times, you come here on a very limited visa, so invest your time in the right direction. Publish some papers. If you're good at technology, if you're good at data science and data mining and all that, why not publish a paper about what's happening in the blockchain world? Why not publish a paper about what's happening in the IoT world or artificial intelligence? Or if you're into mechanical engineering, why not to publish a paper about what's the current trend going on right now? Take that published paper and upload it on LinkedIn and all the other social media so that people know that you are expert at this particular area and topic. Create your niche. Yes, as I said, you have to be good at something very specific. That's what Germans like. You have to define your area very well. It's like triangle, you know. You start from broad, but at the end of the day, you boil it down. Last is Eventbrite is an app which I used to use for networking. So any event happening in your city, this app will allow you free access in this event, plus drink, plus food, and the connections. So what more do you want? If I have to highlight some of the points which you must do, it is first, learn German language. All right, update your LinkedIn. Try to find internship, at least one, if not two. Eventbrite, super important, okay? Publish at least 2 papers in your whole academics. Yeah, that's all. Alright guys, that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed it, hit that thumbs up button and make sure that you share this on your social media. Probably someone who's looking for studying MBA in Germany might be helpful for them. And if you have any specific question regarding MBA, make sure that you reach out to my team on JNM Education's Instagram. Also, you can reach out to me. Yeah. Alright, for now, take care. Bye-bye.